Energy, pero gusto siguro dinner. We can do more.
Yes, we can.
Okay, certainly, when he said one of the important elements of internationalization is unity, and in unity there has to be diversity, no? Mixing Philippines and Indonesia. No? So this time, for the introduction of the guest speaker, may I request the Director for External and International Linkages, Dr. Noordin D. Salam. A round of applause.
With courtesy to our President, Dr. Srimati Dilda, the Vice President for Academic Affairs, Research and Extension, Dr. Teng Adim, and Vice President for Finance and Administration, Dr. Abunawas Mitalitek. I have the honor to present and introduce our speakers for this afternoon. Our speaker is a graduate of Bachelor of Science of Islamic Theology and Philosophy, an Imam of Bontol Padang, Indonesia. He is a holder of Master of Islamic Revealed Knowledge, Islamic International University of Malaysia, Master of Usuluddin, University of Malaysia, and a PhD of Usuluddin, University of Malaya, Malaysia. He is currently director of the University Muhammadiyah Umrai, and a vice president for Muhammadiyah Umrai on province of Umrai. Riau. Our speaker is an Islamic propagator as well as an international speaker. And he loves to discuss Islamization as well as internationalization of Islamic education. The term Amin is one of the characteristics of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as when he reached the age of puberty, he was awarded and named as Amin due to his ability to unite the people of Makkah during the conflict times. The four tribes, Banu Qaynuqa and Banu Nadir and the rest, are fighting against each other, you know, for the purpose, the reason of putting the black stone at the Kaaba, because that was after the flooding. When the Prophet Muhammad, because they decided that we will be going to settle ourselves if there is a first person who will enter Masjid al-Haram. And it so happened that Nabi Muhammad entered very early at the mosque. Masjid al-Haram, and he was asked to settle the issue. What the Prophet Muhammad did, he requested a mantle, and he asked the four tribes to hold the corners of the mantle, the piece of fabric, and put the black stone in between the mantle, and then bring it to the Kaaba, and that's the symbol of equality. And by that, he was named as Al-Amin, the trustworthy. Ladies and gentlemen, the speaker cannot come here without bearing the name. I know he was chosen by the University Muhammadiyah Riau as one of our blessing this afternoon. Alhamdulillah, let us help you welcome Brother Dr. Sayyidul Amin, Rector of
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillahilladzi arsala rasulahu bil huda wa dinil haq liyudhhirahu 'alad dini kullih walau karihal musyrikun. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh la nabiyya ba'da. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Qala Allahu ta'ala fil Qur'anil Karim, A'udzu billahi minasy syaithanir rajim. Wa man ahsanu qawlan mimman da'a ila Allah wa 'amila shaliha wa qala innani minal muslimin. Respectable Professor Dr. Sima G. Dilna, the President of Kota Batu State University. Dr. Kundo M. Paham, Vice President for Academic Affairs. Dr. Teng A. Alim, Vice President for Research, Extension and Productions. Dr. Abu Nawas, Philippine Abu Nawas. I strongly support him. I think he is a professor in Islamic studies. He has very deep knowledge about Islamic epistemology. I respect him. Professor Dr. Said Amin, my real brother. Dr. Nurdin D. Salam, Director External and International Linkage. All deans, head department, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Before we discuss about Islamization of knowledge, I would like to introduce about Muhammadiyah movement. Muhammadiyah movement established in Yogyakarta, 1912. By Kiai Haji Ahmad Dahlan. Today, Muhammadiyah has 178 universities. So Muhammadiyah has universities more than our government has universities. Muhammadiyah has 635 orphan house to keep the orphan. Al-Yatim, di Lugha Al-Arabiya Al-Yatim. Muhammadiyah also have 102 pesantren in Indonesia, maybe in Kota Batu, madrasah, traditional madrasah. We study Quran, hadis, especially Arabic language, and dorm. In pesantren, we have dorm, dormitory. Muhammadiyah also has 457 hospitals around Indonesia, and 437 Baitul Mal. And 762 small Islamic bank. Until now, we have 19,951 schools around Indonesia. Yeah, from TK, that meaning kindergarten, yes, until high school. Yeah. And we also have 13,000 mosques. And Muhammadiyah has 60 million members.
I think 60 million more than Malaysia population. Because as far as I know, Malaysian population not more than 40 million. Not more than 40 million. I'm not sure about Philippine population. That's all about Muhammadiyah. Ladies and gentlemen, if we discuss about Islamization of knowledge, the concept of Islamization of knowledge still controversy. Many Muslim scholars proponent and many of them opponent. The proponent say that knowledge value landed. The opponent say that knowledge value free. Why knowledge value landed? Because many, many Western scientists they are secularists. Some of them free thinker, and many of them agnosticism. Many, many of them nihilism. And today, majority of Western scientists, for example, Weber, Fred William Nietzsche, Marx, Lenin, are atheism. That means knowledge is value landed. The opponent say that knowledge is value free. The value of knowledge is according to its user, not according to knowledge itself. Until now, this is still controversy. I just would like to discuss about Islamization of knowledge. The first one, what is the Islamization of knowledge? Muslim scholars from Iran, Nasser, he said Islamization of knowledge is incorporating aspect of Sufi values into science so that is worldly and has an afterlife orientation. Nasser means knowledge not only for today, but knowledge also for hereafter, for the day of judgment. In Arabic, we can say Yawm al-Qiyamah. So, knowledge, the orientation of knowledge, not only fi hadhihi dunya, for our world today, but also fil akhirah, the hereafter, the day of judgment. How to combine between knowledge for today and knowledge for the hereafter? This is the simple meaning of Islamization of knowledge. So, if my beloved brother, Dr. Abu Nawas Philippine, teach his students, he does not transform of knowledge, but also transform of values. Because all the knowledge, the result of all knowledge, the ultimate of all knowledge is at-tauhid. This is the science according to Islamic teachings. As we know, The first verse in the Quran is Iqra. Iqra. Bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. Khalaqal insana min 'alaq. Iqra wa rabbukal akram. Alladhi 'allama bil qalam. 'Allama al-insan ma lam ya'lam. Iqra. The essential meaning of Iqra is read. But also research. But also find the knowledge. But we don't forget the ultimate goal of knowledge is in the last of the verse. Wasjud waqtarib. So, Iqra, read, make research, find something about knowledge. But the result is, the ultimate goal is wasjud waqtarib. We must obey to Allah. Taqarrub ilallah zulfa. That means the result of the sign or knowledge is at-tawheed. Professor Dr. Said Naqib Al-Attas said Islamization of knowledge is incorporating Islamic values into scientific elements. So how to combine Islamic knowledge, how to combine Islamic values into modern science? So if we discuss about medicine, for example, we also must refer to Islamic heritage. We discuss about Ibn Sina, the father of medicine. If we discuss about sociology, we must refer to Ibn Khaldun. If we refer to math, we must refer to Abdul Jabbar, Ibn Hayyan, Ibn Haytham. If we discuss about economy, we must refer to Abu Ubaid, then Adam Smith, always translate the concept of economy Abu Ubaid into his book. And one presentation in Al-Azhar University said that Adam Smith influenced by Abu Ubaid in on his book Al-Kitab Al-Aqwa. So according to Al-Attas, Islamization of knowledge is how to combine Islamic values into scientific element. Al-Faruqi is a professor of comparative religions in Temple University. He said, Islamization of knowledge is At-Tawheed becomes the foundation of science. At-Tawheed becomes the foundation of science. If I translate into Kota Batu language, what is our language? Mindanao language, yeah. At-Tawheed becomes the foundation of science is At-Tawheed asasul ulum wal ilm. At-tawhid asasul ulum. Awwalu at-tawhid wa akhiru at-tawhid. The first is tawhid, the last also tawhid. Because tawhid the source of knowledge. This is according to Al-Faruqi. Al-Qazi, one of our professor from Pakistan, he was a professor in Sydney. He said the Islamization of knowledge is Islamization of modern empirical knowledge as an effort to assimilation what is good in this knowledge in an Islamic framework. This is very clear. How our modern knowledge based on Islamic framework. So the knowledge must on the Islamic framework. This is Professor Kadhi said. Our former rector in Islamic International University, Professor Dr. Abdul Hamid Abu Sulaiman, he said, the Islamization of knowledge is the type of knowledge based upon revealed norms and ideal of the divine message. So, I think that knowledge must based on revelations. Al-ilmu masdaruha al-wahd. Hadha huwa the simple meaning of Islamization of knowledge. I would like to conclude the many definitions of Islamization knowledge. As Professor Dr. Muhammad Abu Imara said, he is a former rector of University of Al-Azhar in Egypt, he said, Islamization of knowledge is idabul alaqa bain al-ulum awil ma'arif wa bain as-sunan al-ilahiyya allati ja'a biha al-wahyu fil qawm wal insan wal ijtima wa kadhalika tawzi' hadhihi al-ulum wal ma'arif an tariq aslamat al-aslamatha li tahqiq al-maqasid wal ghayat al-shar'iyyah allati haddathaha al-wahyu. Hadha huwa natijah or conclusion from Professor Muhammad Imara, yakni Islamization of knowledge is how to combine, how to fulfill Islamic teachings in our modern science today. This is the simple conclusion about the Islamization of knowledge. Brother and sister, ladies and gentlemen, there are steps of Islamization of knowledge. According to Al-Faruqi, the first step is to master the modern discipline and social science. How in Arabic we can say, ma'rifatul al-waqi', ma'rifatul al-ulum al-hadithah. We must understand the modern science, because after the era of Spain, all the knowledge transferred from Islamic world to Western world. Many Islamic books translated into Latin, after that to many European languages. At the time until now, Western become the source of knowledge, the center of knowledge. So the first step for Islamization of knowledge is how to master, how to understand the modern disciplines of social science, the modern knowledge. The second one, to master the Islamic legacy in those fields. In Arabic, maybe we can say, ma'rifatu at-turas al-Islam, understand Islamic heritage. Like I said before, we must understand the classical book of Islam. If we discuss about medicine, we must read Al-Kitab, Al-Qanun, translated into English, the Canon, written by Ibn Sina. If we discuss about economy, we must read the books of Al-Amwal, alladhi katabahu Abu Ubaid. If we discuss about history, we must discuss about Tarikh al-Tabari or Tarikh ibn Khalqan, that is the very concrete talent discussed about Islamic history. Because if we just discuss about many, many books that rated by Western scholars, sometimes there are many, many bias about the interpretation about our Islamic history. So understand about Islamic heritage is one of the important thing to understand the Islamization of knowledge. The next one, to establish the relevance of Islam to the age of just modern disciplines. At-tawfiq bayna al-Islam wal-ulumul haditha. How to establish between Islamic knowledge and Western or modern knowledge. Next one, to creatively synthesize Islamic values and legacy with modern social science. Synthesis. Maybe Dr. Abu Nawas can explain very detail about synthesis, about synthesize between Islamic teachings and modern knowledge. This is very important. The last one, to launch Islamic thought towards the fulfillment of the divine patterns of Allah. This is the last stage of Islamization of knowledge. Some of Muslim thinkers say that the ultimate goal of Islamization of knowledge, how we can produce science and knowledge from our source of knowledge. What is our source of knowledge? Al-Quran and Sunnah. We don't need refer to Western, we don't need refer to anywhere. We can build the epistemology of Islam from the source of Islam itself, yakni Al-Quran was Sunnah. Brother and sister, ladies and gentlemen, the Islamization of knowledge at our university, in the University of Muhammadiyah Riau. Maybe my sister Dwi will explain in detail, because he is one of the lecturer of Islamic studies in our university. And our brother Fahmi also will explain in detail about the process Islamization of knowledge in our university. But there are three steps also to teach, to practice Islamization of knowledge in our university. The first one is theoretical. We must discuss about the principle of Islam in theoretically. What is the Islam? What is the Iman? What is the pillars of Islam? What is the pillars of Iman? We discuss about this problem theoretically. After that, we must practice all the aspects of philosophies in our Islamic understanding. We cannot say that sholat is wajib, but we must practice that sholat is wajib. So in our university today, rector must be the imam every sholat. If rector went out, the vice rector will replace him. If all vice rector went out, the Dean of Faculty of Islamic Studies can be imam in every sholat. So we start from the simple meaning. When we from the we start the, from the simple one. We start from the humble one. We sincerely believe. Maybe it is simple, but meaningful. If we discuss about wakaf, if we discuss about zakat, if we discuss about kurban, rector, vice rector, and all dean must practice the concept in our daily life. So, the last one is combinations between theoretical and practical. Today in our university, the student cannot be one of cannot be finish his study in our university if he cannot if he or she cannot read Quran well. If he is a male student, he must can be a khatib, you know khatib?
Yes. Giving sermon.
Yeah, that's fine. They must show the certificate. I can read Quran well. This is from life, the institution Islam and Kemuhammadiyahan. If he can show the certificate, he can finish the study in our university. Because we afraid today, there are many Muslim students but cannot read Quran well. This is our moral responsibility. Brother and sister, so today I just discuss about Islamization of knowledge and integration and internationalization. I will explain if you are come to our university in Riyadh.
Inshallah.
If you visit our university in Riyadh, we will make an international seminar from Thailand, Malaysia, and Philippines to discuss this problem in detail and deep. Before I end the speech, I hope as a lecture of Islamic teachings, maybe Devi can explain his experience in University of Muhammadiyah Riau. Please, Madam Devi.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
To Mr. Rector, Pak Rector, to give us the lecture today. Well, we are able to explain a little bit more in our campus. So, actually, in our campus, student is not all Muslim. We also have a Christian student also, but they also we want to transfer our value Islamic. See, so even they are Christian also, we teach them Islamic and Muhammadiyah. Religion is all about, and of course. In our religion, we should cover our bodies here, our aurat, right? So even they are not Muslim, we want them to use outfit like Muslim, even not use the hijab like this. So from my experience, they really respect about the regulation, the practice, and some of them even not Muslim, the grade, the pointer that they got, higher than Muslim. See, it's really surprise for us. So the practice for the Islamic student, like Pak Rektor said just now, we hope that our graduate, of course, can read our Quran. You know, because we can face the world. We don't want our generation to lose out. And so in the process, we hope before finish the university, all of students can read our Quran. It's not easy, of course. So in faculty Islamic studies, we have a scholarship for the Hafiz, they study in university without pay, but the Tafis have should have a rule to teach the student who cannot read Al Quran. He has to be a mentor for the one group of the student. So during the process until they finish the study and they follow the test. Okay, read Al Quran is really compulsory for us before finish the study. So hopefully this is the way us to transfer our knowledge, yeah, our ego also. So Islamic value also, we don't allow even lecturer or student cannot smoke in this area campus, cannot smoke in the rest of campus. So outfit all, yeah, Muslim, non-Muslim also cover. If the Muslim use hijab, non-Muslim just cover the body without hijab. So also we also we practice also solah and salatul janazah also in our campus. Maybe they have a program every 2 weeks. We have we have an institute department in our campus who responsible to deliver the Muhammadiyah and Islamic. They also make lecturing. It's not even for a student, for the all lecturer also. We practice. Because as you know, our lecture is not all the basic Muhammadiyah organization movement. Sometimes there are different movements, so we explain to the new lecture. This is every semester. So it means the lecture can transfer the value, what is the Muhammadiyah, to the student. So we give the training also to the lecture. So maybe Mr. Fahmi want to share something, please. You assalamualaikum
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, thank you very much. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, I just want to add some more information about some practical activities we have been doing in our university. I still remember last time I went through the process of becoming the dean at Faculty of Education. And in order to be able to be in that position to become the deans, the head of departments, and also I think vice rectors, so we need to go through Al-Islam Muhammadiyah test. And Pak Rektor already mentioned, and also Madam Dean already mentioned, that the students are prepared to be able to recite Al-Quran. And if you want to be in the top management as well, we need to do the test. So it is not fair to give the test to the students, but also to be for the lecturers as well. Because yes, as the top management, we need to take turn becoming the khatib every Friday, and then we need to give lecture, like Islamic teaching a little bit for maybe 7 minutes after Zuhur. So every Zuhur in our mosque, we will take turn giving simple speech, you know, maybe even reciting one ayah to the jama'ah, right, to the people coming to the mosque. And also, it is not only the lecture for 7 minutes in the mosque, but also in our classrooms. And right now, if I'm not mistaken, in every classroom, it is the university provides Al-Quran on the table, meaning that before we start the lecture, the study, we need to recite Al-Quran together with our students. And some lecturers as well, they will like make lists. For example, in the first meeting, one student will be appointed to give a simple lecture, and then the following meeting until the last meeting, so taking turn for the students. Because this is actually a good phenomenon, but a bit challenging for shy people, for shy lecturers, maybe they are not confident. You know, in Indonesia, if you are from, let's say, a village, and then you study in university, when you come back, maybe during holiday, the villagers, the people in your village, will think that you are able to become khatib in Jum'ah prayer, in Friday prayer. You are able to, even if you are major, for example, in math, there's nothing to do with the religion, right? You are learning math in university. But when you come back to your village, people will learn, okay, please become khatib. Please give speech, something like that. So this is actually quite challenging. And that's why in our university, we try to help our students, preparing them to be able to recite Al-Quran, to be able to become khatib with that confidence. And I remember, like now, we have in our university, there are three test in order to graduate from the university. The first one is proposal defense. The second one is a result seminar. After collecting the data, analyzing the data, they have to do the test. And the last one is comprehensive examination. In every comprehensive examinations, the student will be assessed on not only about their knowledge, but also about Muhammadiyah and Al-Islam. So they will, for example, I'm the examiner, and I will ask my student to recite, please recite Iqra, please recite this surah, please recite that surah, something like that. So this is a kind of test, because at the end, when they graduate from the university, they will receive two certificates. The first one is undergraduate certificate, the second one is a certificate of reciting Al-Quran competence from this Institute for Islamic Studies. And also, as I remember, in every first semester, so we welcome new students, and then all of them have to study English for all departments. It's not only from English department, but for all departments, they need to take the course for one semester. And just like what Pak Rektor already mentioned, we need to provide the book. And we are thinking, like, in one, for example, in every unit, for example, we have 10 units. In every unit, one way to integrate Al-Quran is to refer to Islamic scholars. For example, Abdul Sina, so we have a unit about medicine, about science, for example. We need to include Islamic scholars. Still, actually, some students, when they do assignment, they might do some research on Google and lots of sources from, you know, Western scholars. But we try to encourage them, okay, we are talking about modern science, but please find some sources. For example, these sources, Islamic scholars. So I think that's what I can say, just additional information, what we have been doing so far as a way of integrating Islam into the modern science in our university. Thank you very much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Back to Pak Rektor, please.
Thank you very much. Brother and sister, ladies and gentlemen, not only for students. In our university, if you would like to be a head department, vice dean, vice rector, and also rector, there are many tests. One of the tests is Islamic understanding. So, if you would like to be a head department, a vice dean, vice rector, and rector, the first one,
you must can read Al-Quran well. The second one, you must active in Islamic movement, especially Muhammadiyah. If you can read Al-Quran well, but you don't active in Islamic movement, that is meaningless. The last one, you must have a good understanding, you must have a good understanding of Islamic teaching. So if you pass in the test, you can be a head department, you can be a vice dean, vice rector, and rector. Brother and sister, ladies and gentlemen, the principle of Muhammadiyah education is education from Muhammadiyah, but for all people. If we go to Western Indonesia, like Ambon, Papua, Nusa Tenggara, there are also many, many universities. One day, I went to Maumere. When I will start my speech, the rector of University Muhammadiyah Maumere come to me and say, Pak Rektor, please pay attention. We have 4,000 students, but 80% of our students are Christian. In Maumere, there are 4,000 students. 80% from all the students are Christian. Gorontalo also, Papua, but they can live in our university in harmony. This is the simple meaning of tasamu. In English we can say tasamu, tolerance, according to Muhammadiyah teaching. Brother and sister, ladies and gentlemen, the summary of this humble presentation is the essence of science and knowledge is Tauhid. The ultimate goal of Islamic of knowledge is also Tauhid. So the civilization must be in the line with God's will, with Allah's will. This is the principle of our life, also in our education system. Okay, thank you very much. Syukran jazira. May Allah will always bless us. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.